Responding to outrage about cuts in military pensions, even senators voting yes on the budget demanded benefits be restored.
I believe this mistake must be corrected.
These heroes lay their lives on the line for us, and they deserve us to work to fix this provision so that they can receive the full benefits that they've earned.
To salvage her bipartisan deal, Democratic Budget Chair Patty Murray promised to push new legislation to make sure disabled veterans who lost limbs and worse fighting America's wars won't lose their retirement benefits, even vowing to revisit the whole $6.2 billion cut for military retirees.
This action, military action, actually doesn't take effect for 2 years. So we welcome anybody coming with a better way to do it that want to offer it and get it through a divided Congress.
At issue, a 1% drop in the cost of living adjustment for service members who retire after 20 years, generally people in their 40s. The cut would be restored at age 62. In real terms, a retiring Army Sergeant First Class would lose $3,700 each year. Over 20 years, that could add up to $80,000 in lost benefits. A cut infuriating vets across the country, like in this online petition from Iraq and Afghanistan veterans. "Who amongst the politicians have given as much in the same conditions as I have," writes one vet. "Our service should be respected more than this," said another.
"Of all the people we could have picked on to screw, how could we arrived here? How could we have done this?"
Despite that anger, Lindsey Graham's best Senate friend and influential military vet disagrees. John McCain argues cuts in military pensions are needed, noting it cost $52 billion last year and skyrocketed 49% over 10 years.
"In the words of former Secretary of Defense, Mr. Gates said that these entitlements in the military are, quote, eating us alive.